Subbatches are an optional configuration element that can be added to unit batches. Parallel subbatches and subsequent subbatches are permitted, and there's no limit to the number or type of subbatches. The only limitation is that each subbatch has to be completely contained within a unit batch. That means when the unit batch trigger ends the unit batch, it's going to end all your subbatches too. So you need to make sure that the subbatches are coordinated and completely contained within a unit batch. It's very easy to set up subbatches using the system manager tools. The basic steps are to create a unit batch. Obviously, it's required for the subbatch. You can optionally create a PI heading set. Heading sets are part of some batch standards, and we do accommodate them. They don't hold or enforce any hierarchy, but they can be used in searching and labeling and things like that. And then you simply configure your subbatches using the PIBaGen plugin that we've been using all along. Save the new configuration, and your subbatch configuration is complete. Some batch standards call for heading sets. Heading sets are simply labels that are assigned to subbatches, and they can be accommodated for in the PI batch generator. When you set up a subbatch, you will be asked for a heading set to use. The heading set has entries like operation, phase, level, whatever you want to use, and it's used. It's created using the module database. So you would go into the operation plugin and look under heading sets and create a new one. And then once you created your new heading set, you could then edit it and give it whatever name and entries you want to give it. So let's go into the operation tab of our SMT, look up module database and expand it. And before you even get to the module, there's an entry called heading sets. So I'll right click and select new. That will give me something that's using the default name new set. I can double click on that and change the name to whatever I want. So I'll call this levels, and I simply give them numbers and labels. The heading is what will show up in the labels. So if I could use the term top and middle and bottom, and this would imply a three-layer or three-step heading set that I have. If I save and exit, I can then use each of those headings in my subbatches. So I could refer to each of them as top, middle, or bottom. Again, the heading sets are optional. They're simply labels that are used to identify the different subbatches. And they're, even though they are numbered with levels, there is no hierarchy that's enforced. The PIBatch hierarchy is enforced using the PIBatch generator and the hierarchical structure that you build within it. If we look at the one of the examples that we had earlier, we had a sample batch module, and we used the unit batch to set up the basic unit batch parameters. The subbatch area is used to set up any sublevels or subbatches that you have. So let's say, for example, I had two steps in this batch. I could add a new subbatch title and call this step one, and I could add another subbatch and call this step two. If either of these steps had so let's say phases to them, I could add a new subbatch under step one and call this step 1A. And then step one could have a new subbatch, and this could be called step 2A. Now, all of these batches and subbatches are configured hierarchically here, and each one of them, each subbatch level that you have, has to have its own active point, its own trigger. So we have to know when these subbatches come in and when they're to be activated. So each subbatch must have an active point, and if you don't define that, then that subbatch or any children below it will not be created. And this active point, again, like the unit batch, is going to define the start and the end time of your batch. Remember that your active points or triggers have to completely be within the PIUnit batch. If the unit batch is stopped or not started, your subbatch will not occur. So you define your active point, you have the exact same configuration parameters that you had with your unit batches. You can use an integer, digital or discrete, or string type tag, and they're set up with the exact same format. So I can check pulse, step, and if I select step, I can select continuous. And if this was a string that I selected, my string indicating zero state would show up here in the input box. Now the subbatch name, you have one of three choices. You can either use the name that you gave it in the hierarchy. You can use the value that the active point contains. So if the active point contains a string or some other nomenclature that you want to use, you can do that. Or you can pick a completely different PI point to read for the name of the subbatch. So you have these three options. And then if you choose one of the heading sets that you've created, the levels will be applied to the levels of your hierarchy. So everything at level one, the first level is level one, everything at level one will get the level one entry of your hierarchy. So if I use the heading set levels and I go back and I look at my module database with my heading sets, level one happens to read top. So each of these step one and step two would get top. My level two is called middle. So everything under level two would get the heading middle. Again, there's no hierarchy enforced. There's no functionality implied. There's simply labels telling you, if you use a heading set, what level your subbatches live at.